Hi, Mickey here with Forevermore Computer Training. In this video, we are going to take a look at the ruler. In Word, you can quickly set up margins, tab stops, and paragraph indents right on the horizontal ruler. What you learn in this video will apply to versions of Microsoft Word 2007 to the current version. I will be demonstrating with Word 2016, so depending on what version you are using, my screen may look slightly different. After watching this video, you will be able to improve alignment by using tab stops, apply indents to control text alignment, adjust left, right, top, and bottom margins. You will be a ruler of Word. Before we get started, let's review the ruler. At the top of the Word document is the horizontal ruler. Here is the left margin, the first line indent, hanging indent, left indent, right indent, and right margin. The gray area on both sides is the margin area. The white area is the writing space of your document. To the far left are the tab stops. By default, the left tab is showing. I will toggle through the different tab stops. Center tab, right tab, decimal tab, bar tab. There is also the first line and hanging indent, and then back to the left tab. Although Word's rulers, both horizontal and vertical, are displayed by default, for some reason they may not be showing. If you don't see anything at the top or side of your screen that looks like a ruler, here's what to do. Go to the View tab and select Ruler. First line indent will indent just the first line of a paragraph. Place the insertion point in front of the first paragraph and move the marker to a point on the ruler. If I select multiple paragraphs, the first line of each selected paragraph is indented. Hanging indent will indent all the text except the first line. The left indent moves both the first line and hanging indent markers at the same time. Use the right indent if you want to make the paragraph narrower. You often see this with quoted text. This is also a great way to adjust or troubleshoot a numbered or bulleted list. In this example, notice that the numbering is slightly misaligned here. By adjusting the first and hanging indent, I can get all the numbers to align. You have probably noticed the guideline that appears when moving the indent markers. This is very helpful when you're trying to align text or numbers. The ruler can be used to set left and right page margins, but only in page layout or print layout view. If you hover your mouse just above the left indent or right indent marker, you will see that the pointer changes to a double-sided horizontal arrow, and the screen tip says left margin or right margin. When you get the double-sided arrow, click, hold, and drag the mouse to adjust the margin. We have only talked about the horizontal ruler so far, but you can also adjust the top and bottom margins from the vertical ruler. It works basically the same way. Now let's take a look at setting tabs. The default is the left tab marker. Click on the ruler and you will have set a tab stop. You will see the small L on the ruler. You can move these tab stops as needed. Just click and drag it where you need it. To remove a tab, simply click, hold, and drag it off the ruler. Let's set up some other tab stops. Let's say I have a list of names, their position, and salary. I will toggle to the center tab, and I will place it on the 1-inch mark. Now I toggle to the next tab and set the right tab at the 3-inch mark. Again, I toggle to the next tab, which is the decimal tab, and I will set it at the 5-inch mark. I want to set a bar tab, mainly so you can see what you can do with this. I will set it at the 4-inch mark. Okay, now I'm ready to enter some data. I will hit the tab on my keyboard, and this takes me to the first tab that I set. Let's start with Susan. I'm going to type out Susan, tab, president, tab, and salary, 100,000. Enter to go to the next line, tab again. I'm going to type in Wesley, tab, vice president, tab, 75,000. I think that is enough information for you to get the idea. The names are centered under the center tab, the positions are right aligned, and the salary is aligned by the decimal under the decimal tab. And you can see that the bar tab has created a border between the position and the salary.